Hi dear students, welcome back to the maths class. In our previous class, we learned finding the coefficient of the expansions as well as we solved one question related to find the term independent of x. This question I just given for you to practice. I don't know how many you have done. Let us solve this question in this class. Solution. Find the general term. So here n equals to 18, here n equals to 18, then the general term is what? Tr plus 1. Before that, in the expansion we have the sign plus, then no need to write minus 1 whole power r. That's it. Remaining things are same, ncr x power n minus r into y power r. Right, now in place of x we have cube root x, so tr plus 1 equals to n, in place of n 18, cr x power n minus r, 18 minus r into y power r. In place of x, we have cube root x, right? In place of y, we have 1 by 2 into cube root x. 1 divided by 2 into cube root x. Okay. Now simplified, I already told you in the previous class that how many x are there 2x, 1 2, number of x 2x are there. We have to simplify this general term till 1x will comes. Right, remember that if there is two number of x is there in the general term, then we have to find till 1x will comes. Okay, let us simplify. I'm just using new sheet so that you kindly write in your notebook. Tr plus 1 equals to 18 cr, keep it as it is. Cube root x is also can be written as, inserts root x. How we will write root x is 1 by 2. Cube root x, how you are going to write cube root x? X power 1 by 3. Fourth root x power 1 by 4, right? Similarly, fifth root x power 1 by 5, like that and so on. So cube root x is also can be written as x power 1 by 3, isn't it? These things already you learn in your lower classes. X power 1 by 3 whole power 18 minus r, okay? Into next 1 power r divided by 2 power r, cube root x whole power r. Cube root x is also can be written as x power 1 by 3, isn't it, by using the concept of surds, right? Next, I'm just removing this sheet, the first sheet. Before that, you kindly take a screenshot or you may pause the video. You just note down in your notebook. I'm just removing this sheet. This sheet disturbing for me to make a class properly. Okay, I'm just removing this sheet. That is equals to t r plus 1 equals to 18 c r 18 c r x power 1 by 3 into 18 minus r, that is what, that's what, 18 minus r by 3 into 1 power r, we know that 1 power r value is 1, divided by 2 power r, 2 power r, just keep it as it is, into x power 1 by 3 into r is x power r divided by 3. Next, t r plus 1 equals to 18 c r x power 18 minus r by 3 into, in the denominator we have x power r by 3, in the denominator we have x power r by 3, if it goes to numerator, then what will becomes, this will goes to the numerator, then what will becomes x power minus r by 3 divided by 2 power r, right, by using the concept of thirds, by using the concept of loss of exponents, t r plus 1 equals to 18 c r x power, once again, x power, I mean bases are same, then base is same, then we can add the powers, how, x power 18 minus r, 18 minus r divided by 3 minus r by 3, r divided by 3 into 1 by, in the denominator we have 1 by 2 power r. Okay, next, t r plus 1 equals to 18 c r into x power, LCM will be 3, 18 minus r is 2 r into 1 divided by 2 power r. See, I already told you in the first step itself that then in the first step we have, you just see the first step of this problem. In your notebook, you just see the first step of this problem. For in the first step, I mean in the general term, we have two number of x. I mean number of x will be 2, right? I already told you that we have to simplify that till single x will comes, right? Here we have only single x, I mean one x is there. Here we have to stop the general term. I mean here we have to stop the simplification because we need only single x, only one x we need, right? Next, the term independent of x means what? We have to equate the powers of x equals to 0. We have to equate the powers of x equals to 0, right? Put 18 minus 2 r by 3 equals to 0. 18 minus 2 r by 3 equals to 0. Simplify it. 18 minus 2 r equals to 3 into 0 is 0. 18 equals to 2 r. 2 ones are 2 nines are. Then r equals to 9. Now, substitute this r equals to 9 in this equation. I mean, general term. T 9 plus 1 equals to 18 c 9 into x power. 18 minus 2 r by 3 equals to what? 0, we have taken 0 into 1 divided by 2 power 9. Next, t 9 plus 1 equals to 18 c 9 into 1 by 2 power 9. X power 0 is 1. Therefore, this will be the term independent of x. This will be the term independent of x. If you want to simplify this, you can simplify. Or else you can stop here itself. Okay, understand? Yes, write the conclusion. Therefore the term independent of x is 18 c 9 into 1 by 2 power 9, right? Okay, now I will just scroll this sheet step by step. You just note down, I mean step by step, you just make a note in your notebook. Kindly write proper points, proper presentation should be there in your notebook. Are you understand? I hope everyone has understood. Now let us move on to the next question. See, we have the next question. In the expansion of 1 plus a whole power m plus n, prove that the coefficient of a power m and a power n are equal. You just observe the question. In the expansion 1 plus a whole power m plus n, in the expansion 1 plus a whole power n whole power m plus n, prove that the coefficient of a power m and a power n are equal. Okay, we have to prove that the coefficient of a power m and the coefficient of a power n are equal. We need to find the coefficients of a power m and a power n, right? We need to find the coefficient of a power m and a power n. Before that, find its general term. Before that, find its general term. So these kinds of questions are important for your examination as well as CET. These kinds of questions is also important for CET. Okay, find out its general term. General term. So general term tr plus 1 equals to, before that, in the expansion we have the sign plus. If there is a sign plus, then no need to write minus 1 whole power r. Minus 1 whole power r will not be there. NCR, m plus n, okay, NCR x power n minus r into y power r. It is the general term. Next, tr plus 1 equals to n. In place of n, we have what? In place of n, we have m plus n. Okay, in place of n, we have m plus n. So, m plus n cr x power. In place of x, what we have? 1 only. In place of x, we have 1 only. 1 power n minus r. m plus n minus r into y power r. In place of y, we have a power r. tr plus 1 equals to m plus n cr. 1 power m plus n minus r is what? 1 power r is what? 1 power n is 1. 1 square is 1. 1 cube is 1. 1 power 10 is 1. 1 power 10 lakhs is also 1. 1 power 0 is 1. 1 power m is 1. Similarly, 1 power m plus n minus r is what? 1 only. So no need to write 1 once again. You just write a power r. Okay, a power r. Now here we have the general term, that tr plus 1 equals to m plus n cr a power r. Now I'm going to use the next sheet, the new sheet I'm going to use, so that you just note down in your notebook. If you want to take a screenshot, you can take, or else you can pause the video. I will move on to the next sheet, the new page. So it is the general term, call this as equation number 1. Now you just observe the question, in the expansion of 1 plus a whole power m plus n, prove that the coefficient of a power m and a power n are equal. That means we need to find the coefficient of a power m. We have to find, okay, at the same time we have to find the coefficient of a power n also, because we have to prove that a power m and a power n, those coefficients are equal. Recall the concept of finding the coefficient of the particular expansion. I already told you in the previous classes itself, while finding the coefficients, there I already told you that we have to find the coefficient of a power m, then we need to equate a powers. A power is m, a power is r. We need to equate the powers of a. powers of A, R equals to M. Put R equals to M. Put R equals to M in equation 1. That's it. Put R equals to M in equation number 1. T, M plus 1, in place of R, you put M. T, M plus 1, M plus N, C, M into A power M. A power M. Similarly, what about the coefficient of A power 1? A power N. We need to find the coefficient of A power N, then put N equals to R. I mean, equate the powers of A. Put R equals to N in equation 1. In equation 1. Then T, N plus 1 equals to M plus N, C, N into A power R. A power N. Okay. Yes. What we need to prove, the coefficient of A power M and the coefficient of A power N are equal. Is these two are equal? No. R, yes. M plus N, C, M. M plus N, C, N. Is these two are equal? Can you guess? Let me see. That is equals to, yes, in combinations we have the formula that NCR equals to N factorial divided by R factorial into N minus R factorial, right? Let us use this combinations formula in this. M plus N factorial divided by M plus N factorial divided by M factorial into M plus N minus M factorial into A power M. Just I used this formula. I mean, just I applied this NCR formula in this M plus N CM. Plus M minus M will get cancelled. That is equals to M plus N factorial divided by M factorial into N factorial into A power M. Okay. Next, similarly, apply this NCR formula in this M plus N CN, then we will get M plus N factorial divided by N factorial into M plus N minus N, M plus N minus N factorial into A power N. Plus N minus N will get cancelled. That is equals to M plus N factorial divided by N factorial into M factorial into A power N. Now, can you say these two are equal? Is these two are equal? Yes, both are equal. M factorial, N factorial is also equals to N factorial, M factorial. Finally, we found that the coefficients of A power M and A power N are equal. M plus N factorial divided by M factorial, N factorial is also equals to M plus N factorial divided by N factorial, M factorial. Therefore, we just write the conclusion. Therefore, coefficient of A power M is also equals to the coefficient of A power N. That's it. Hence, it is the solution for this problem. Now, if you want to take a screenshot, you can take, or else you can pause the video. Kindly write down in your notebook. Now we will move on to the next question. So next question we have, find the positive value of M for which the coefficient of x power 6 in the expansion 1 plus x whole power M is 6. We need to find the positive value of M. I mean, we have to find the value of M. For to find the value of M, he given that the coefficient of x square is 6 in this expansion. Coefficient of x square is 6 in this expansion. Okay. Before that, we have to write the general term. I mean, find out the general term. So, general term general term tr plus 1 equals to ncr x power n minus r into y power r. In this expansion we have the sign plus, then minus 1 whole power r will not be there, that's it. So tr plus 1 equals to n, in place of n what we have m, so mcr x power in place of x we have 1 power m minus r into in place of y we have x power r. Next tr plus 1 is equals to mcr 1 power m minus r, value is what, 1 only, 1 power m minus r, 1 power m plus r, 1 plus 1 power m plus n minus 2r, 1 power m minus n 2r, so all these r values will be 1 only. So 1 power m minus r is 1 only into x power r, no need to write this 1 power m minus r again. So 1 power m minus r value will be 1, kindly do not confuse. Now next, he given that the coefficient of x square is 6. He said that coefficient of x square is 6, therefore the coefficient of x square, coefficient of x square is 6, given that coefficient of x square is 6, x square is 6, isn't it? Yes. How to find the coefficient of x square? We have to equate the powers of x. We have to find the coefficient. Suppose we need to find the coefficient of x square, then we need to equate the powers of x. Then put r equals to 2. Okay. Put r equals to 2. If we put r equals to 2, then what we will get? mc 2 x square. I don't know, maybe you are getting confused. Let us find out the coefficient of x square separately. So let us find out coefficient of x square separately. How to find the coefficient of x square? We need to equate, put r equals to 2, x powers, okay, r equals to 2, then t 2 plus 1 equals to mc 2 into x square. Then the coefficient of x square will be what? mc 2 only. Therefore the coefficient of x square is what? mc 2. Finding the coefficients we already learned in our previous classes, so these steps may be you will get confused, I mean these steps make you to confuse, so that I just find it the coefficient of x square separately. So coefficient of x square, we found that mc 2 is the coefficient. Given that coefficient of x square equals to 6, so coefficient of x square is what? mc2. Substitute these values, mc2 equals to x square, mc2 equals to 6. Now mc2, expand this mc2, what is the formula? How to expand this mc2? What is the formula? We have learned in combinations, ncr equals to n factorial divided by r factorial into n minus r factorial, right? Let us apply this formula for this, or else you can apply the shortest method, what it is? mc2, reduce this m two times, how? M into m minus 1 divided by, reduce this m two times, how? M into m minus 1, next divided by 2 into 1 equals to 6. I understand. If you are getting confused, then you can apply this formula. If you apply this formula, it will be too lengthy, so that I am avoiding this formula. mc2 is also can be written as m into m minus 1 by 2 into 1. Reduce this m 2 times. 2 into m minus 1. decrease this m 2 times, m into m minus 1 by 2 into 1. Next, m into m is m square, m into 1 is minus m, m square minus m equals to, send 2 into 1 is 2, send this 2 to the right, it will be 12, it will be 12. Next, m square minus m, take this plus 12 to the left hand side, that will be minus 12 equals to 0. Okay, m square minus m minus 12 equals to 0. Now it is in the quadratic form. It is in the quadratic form. How to solve these kinds of questions? How to simplify m square minus m minus 12? Before that, I am just using the next page. I am moving to the next page so that before that, you just note down in your notebook. You can take a screenshot or you may pause the video. That's your wish. I will just scroll down this sheet. Now I am moving to the next sheet, next page. So how to solve this m square minus m minus 12 equals to 0? M square minus m minus 12 equals to 0. Minus 12 into 1 is minus 12. Minus 12 factors or what? Minus 12 factors. Multiplication gives minus 12. Addition gives minus 1. Multiplication gives minus 12. Addition gives minus 1. So minus 4 into 3. Minus 4 minus 3. Minus 4 into 3 is minus 12. Minus 4 plus 3 is minus 1. Right? So these things already you have learned in your lower classes as well as in bridge course syllabus, right? So m square minus 4m minus 4m minus 3m minus 12 equals to 0. Take m outside, m minus 4. Next, here you can take minus 3 outside. Now here we can take minus 3 outside, then m minus 4 equals to 0. Take this m minus 4 common, m minus 4 into m minus 3 equals to 0. It will be m plus 3 it is. See, I just made a mistake. Minus 4 plus 3, isn't it? Minus 4 plus 3. Minus 4 plus 3. Then plus 3 is common, m minus 4 will be there. M minus 4 is common, m plus 3. Minus 4m plus 3. Minus 4 plus 3. In this, m is common, m minus 4 plus 3 is common, m minus 4. So m minus 4 into m plus 3 equals to 0. Therefore, m minus 4 equals to 0 or m plus 3 equals to 0. So m equals to 4, m equals to minus 3. Which is possible, which is not possible? See the question in your notebook, that he said that find the positive value of m. He said in the question that find a positive value of m. Which is the positive value? This one or this one? Which is the positive value? 4, isn't it? Therefore, positive value of m equals to 4. That's it. Positive value of m equals to 4. It is not possible. Which is not a positive value. M equals to minus 3 is not a positive value. Therefore, the positive value of m is 4. Are you understand? Okay. So these kinds of questions are important for your point of examination as well as CET or JEE also.